Hey, what's up, folks? How's it going? I got a lot of requests to make a separate video on how to do text, like how to make text bigger, how to fill in the background with a different color, how to change the color of the text itself. I guess that's something I left off the first video, so let's do it. Okay, so let's say that I want to leave a message to the senior class on this page, which is still in development. Okay, perfect. Well, what I'll do is I'll go ahead. Might make my text box kind of large, right? And then you might want to increase the size of the font. So maybe you want to go down to something like 28, right? That's something that could help you here. And I'll say congrats to the senior class, dot dot dot, 100% amazing. Exclamation point. Okay. And then I'm going to make this a size 28. It's important that you select this, click on what you want, and then click apply. Okay. You can rewatch this video a few times if it goes too quickly. This is just a run through. Okay, so that's step one, right? Okay, so I like this. The size is good, but it looks maybe it's a little bit boring, right? So then when you click on this text page again, you'll see there's two options. There's option number one, which is for editing the text, and option number two for colors and borders. Okay, let's edit up this text a little bit and let's make it perhaps a bit more interesting. Okay, so you can scroll through here and find a text that you really like, one that speaks to you. There's hundreds of them, I think 100 of them or something, so just scroll through, take your time and find one that really speaks to you, one you think will match the vibe of your page, fit your personality, however you think that might go. So I'm scrolling, I'm looking for something. I'm the kind of person who just sort of wants to get something good and go with it and maybe change it later. So I click apply. Congrats to the senior class, 100% amazing. Okay, cool, because 100% college acceptance, right? All right, so okay, this is getting better, but it still could use a little spark, right? So, okay, I'll go back to colors and borders. Now, maybe I want a border. A border does something like this. It just gives a nice blocked off feeling to the text itself. You might find this really valuable if you're very geometric, right? It's just very much this much space. That works for me, that works for you. And now you have this nice little box. Perfect. Now, within the box itself, you might want to include some color. You might want to include a splash of something extra just to give that extra flair. Then you're going to go to fill. Fill allows you to fill in with really whatever color you want. Now you can do a dark, deep red. You could do a blue. Whatever works here, again, works for me, works for you. Right? Maybe I don't like that color so much. Maybe I'm thinking more of like a legacy-ish purple. Okay, I think that looks better. More legacy vibe. So then you can fill this, and depending on the amount of transparency you have, that's how deep the color is going to be. So make sure you move the marker away from 0% or 100% transparency, because you won't be able to see anything. And sometimes 0% transparency is really dark, so maybe that's too light. Maybe I like this right here, 55%. And then I apply it. Boom. Text wall is made. Congrats to the senior class, 100% amazing. Now, this looks a lot better. It's a lot more interesting. It's a lot more dynamic to the eye. So, what happens if you do something like this, though? Excuse me. Excuse me. You'll get this exclamation mark, and this is saying, hey, you're outside the lines. You're outside the bounds, so to speak. So, what you'll have to do then is come back until that arrow is gone. Okay, now to show you one more thing, let's say you're doing a group page with multiple people and you choose a dark background. Right? So perhaps you're in Michael's situation where you have this really cool background that you're vibing with, you're totally all about. That's no longer Samantha G, actually. That is now property of Yearbook. We're gonna write you guys a little message. So that's ours. So you might see if you text something in here, it might come across as kind of dark. So this would be a great time to change the formatting around, change the color. You don't have to do this, Michael. I'll change this back for you at the end. So I'll just do it for your book itself. Maybe the text for my name is a little bit small. I want it to be bigger. Okay, cool. Just again, scrolling down here. Maybe size 18 works for me. Maybe it doesn't. Maybe I'll go size right here. Okay, yeah, that's all right for me. Again, you might want to make it bigger. Might want to make it smaller. Maybe you want to do all capitals. Okay, you can also bold this text, highlight this text. Just make sure it's highlighted when you do it, otherwise it'll really be hard to stick to it. Okay. All right, so then because I have this dark background, I'm going to do that text thing we talked about earlier where we change the actual color of the text itself. To do that, I'll click here. Text color, I'm going to change to something vibrant, like yellow, like a shooting star. You know? Perfect. So that works for me. I'm going to say okay. I'm going to say apply to all. Oh, shoot. Apply to all. It applied to my neighbor's stuff as well. So once again, if you have a color, whatever it is, and you apply it, you'll only get it to your section. But if you apply it to all, it'll happen to everybody on your page. So it's really important that you only apply the text color, not apply to all, but simply apply it to your texts. Okay. So I'm here. I selected it, yearbook, right? I'm going to change the text color to, let's say, yellow of some kind. Nice. Then I'm just going to click on apply. And then it'll apply to my text individually right here. Whereas if I click on to apply all, it'll go to everybody's, and that gets kind of messy kind of quick, right? As you can imagine. All right, so I have yearbook. I have this text color. I'll hit OK. I'll hit apply. And again, that might be kind of a silly change in the context of this. You're probably going to want to make it something very bright and vibrant, right? Probably a bright yellow. Click OK. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and apply that. Okay, much better. So now you can see that this yearbook comes out a bit more clearly. I might want to make the title a little bit bigger itself. Again, you can always change the font around to something that suits your personality better, whatever that might be. Some fonts and formats you'll have to make bigger just based off of what you got, but here's what you end up with. All right. Okay, so that's my message to you. If you have any questions, please definitely reach out. Know that I'm here for you, and I'll have office hours next Wednesday and the Wednesday after. From 3:30 to 4 to help you out. Okay. Talk to you soon. Bye.